Thank you. Welcome. My name is Andy Crone, and I have the pleasure of serving as the chair of the Veritas Academy School Board. On behalf of the board, the trustees, the administration, and faculty, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you here tonight in the shade of the John Deal Memorial Heritage Tree and on this very special evening as we celebrate the graduation ceremonies for the Veritas Academy Class of 2023. As we begin, let's have a word of prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, you are the Alpha and Omega and are sovereign over every one of our days. You have given each of us life and the glorious opportunity to know you. Before you, we bring these young men and women. We know that you have loved and cared for each one and that you desire a relationship with them. Draw each of them near to you and continue to nurture them. Keep them firmly rooted in the truth that they have been taught here in their youth, growing them into Christian maturity, coming to know Jesus more and more with each passing day. You have begun a good work in them. Bring it to completion. We thank you for all the individuals you have provided for them. Parents and family members, teachers and coaches, pastors, friends and acquaintances, even those yet to come. For all who have spoken truth, provided wisdom and understanding, and have given selflessly of their time and talents, we praise you as its true source. We treasure each day we have spent with these graduates. We pleasantly recall the blessings of good times, the laughter and victory.
And valedictorian, and the highest honor at Veritas, the Valiant Award. First, I will invite the senior thesis team to honor our top speakers of this year.
Each year, we ask the seniors to do something that most college students would shrink from attempting. They are asked to demonstrate their academic prowess in a 20-minute public speech that they then defend against a panel of judges for another 20 minutes. While for the underclassmen, the thought of thesis week looms menacingly in the distance, thesis week is, for us on the team, a bright point of the year. We get to witness firsthand the camaraderie that grows within the ranks of the seniors, the pride that bubbles in the hearts of parents, and the extra swagger that accompanies the seniors the day after they're done. After each night of thesis presentations, we choose a winner to compete in the final forum. I will ask the four winners to come on stage to be recognized. Hallie Kirsten. Josh Underwood. Sam Haygood. And Eve Pickering. Each of them received $250 from Veritas to their college bookstore. The winner of the final form receives a $2,000 scholarship from an anonymous donor, and this custom top speaker wreath made by myself in the parking lot almost 20 minutes ago from real organic leafery and sometimes wildlife. So without further ado, drum roll please. The senior thesis laureate is Sam Haygood.
Hat off, brother.
He also gets this big silly novelty check. Next up, the top scholars, National Merit and Salutatorians, and Valedictorian.
So, our top scholars at Veritas Academy include our National Merit Scholars. The National Merit Scholarship Program is an academic competition for recognition and scholarships that began in 1955. High school students enter the National Merit Program by taking the PSAT as a junior. We are going to take a moment to recognize the students from the class of 2023 who have been recognized by the National Merit Scholarship Program. Of the 1.5 million juniors who take the PSAT each year, the top 3% are recognized by the National Merit Scholarship Corporation. Two-thirds of the top 3% receive a letter of commendation. The Veritas Academy class of 2023 had four commended students. When I call your name, please come forward. Elijah Blythe. Grace Herstad. Braden Smith. And Josh Underwood. Congratulations. 15,000 students nationwide, representing the top 1% of the 1.5 million entries into the program, are National Merit finalists. The Veritas Academy class of 2023 had two National Merit finalists, Adam Bile and Sam Haygood. The salutatorian is the student with the second highest weighted GPA from among the students who have earned the distinguished diploma. This year's class had a two-way tie for this honor because they were within 4/100ths of a GPA point of one another. One of the salutatorians for the Veritas Academy class of 2023 is Joshua Underwood. The second salutatorian for the class of 2023 is Samuel Haygood. Congratulations, gentlemen. The valedictorian is the student with the highest weighted GPA from among the students who have earned the distinguished diploma. The valedictorian for the Veritas Academy class of 2023 is Margaret Ray Lambden. The valedictorian for the Veritas Academy class will now address their class.
Hello. At a glance, our graduating class of 2023 may not be anything special. Like every other senior class, we've had our failures and our successes. Athletically, we've had our wins, with both volleyball and men's basketball making it to the Final Four this year. And we've had our losses. You know who you are. We've had our senior skip day and subsequent senior service day, and at a glance, our senior class may seem to be plagued with the common Gen Z apathy and entitlement. This is a common diagnosis for our generation. Most agree that this apathy comes from our lack of struggle. They say that because we haven't experienced war firsthand or been forced to skip a meal, we're entitled. But we have struggled. Each and every one of us experienced a global pandemic on a scale thought to be impossible in the modern age. We were born into a post-9/11 era. All we know is don't say bomb and random security checks at the airport. We live in a world where people bring guns to school. We live in a world, last year even, we had to reevaluate what the world we'd be adults in would look like when Russia sent its first troops into Ukraine. We don't live in a world without struggle. We live in a world where tumult has been so normalized that being pulled aside for a random security check at the airport, checking to make sure you aren't carrying drugs, firearms, or being trafficked is a mundane event, not even worth mentioning when someone asks how your flight home was. In this world, apathy seems like the only option because caring about things that you don't think you can change seems insane. It's hard to blame someone for that. And as I've reflected on my 7 years at Veritas, I can see where our apparent disregard for common courtesy has rubbed people the wrong way. Our senior class is one that took the privilege of the senior room and used and abused it to its full potential. The whiteboard that we used to have, I'm sure, was lovingly placed on the wall in hopes that seniors would draw fun pictures or study together. We drew pictures. And with the right attitude, our fart counter could be considered applied statistics. Naturally, the whiteboard was removed before the end of the first semester. I hope that whoever pushed for its removal chalked up the crassness to teenage shenanigans, but it's likely that at some point they sighed and lamented that even this group had fallen victim to the impropriety of our apathetic generation. Maybe they're right at some level, but I think that two of the most important things I've learned at Veritas are that everyone cares about something and that God knows what he's doing, because the class of 2023 is one with a distinct character, dynamic, and love for others that I feel so blessed to have been a part of. Often in high school, it's easy to isolate oneself amongst close friends, assuming that others have nothing to offer you or you have nothing to offer them. Once again, it's easier to seem aloof rather than to seem like you care too much. My senior class doesn't really seem to be bothered by those standards, though. In the same senior room that we've treated with such disregard, anyone can sit down and talk about school, music, teachers, parents, food, really whatever comes to mind. Countless times I've sat in this senior room and talked with a classmate who I'd maybe spoken to twice in my 7 years at Veritas. Our conversations aren't world-changing, but if you just watch how the class of 2023 cares for each other, it's hard to call us apathetic. I know multiple people who went to every single senior thesis, whether they were friends with a speaker or not. It's hard to look at that kind of support and think of entitlement. At a glance, our class of 2023 may be apathetic, but when you talk to underclassmen, they won't tell you how afraid they are of us or how badly we caught senioritis in our final weeks. They'll tell you about how our senior class was always willing to take a junior into the senior room just because we wanted to spend more time with them. They'll tell you about playing chess or doing a crossword puzzle with us during shared off periods. Maybe they'll talk about playing basketball or softball with us or about getting coffee or lunch together. I certainly don't think that our underclassmen would call us apathetic. In the words of the Beatles, living is easy with eyes closed, and it is, but Veritas has taught us that easy won't be good enough for us. It can't be good enough. I think that our eyes are open. God gave us Veritas, and we know what it means to be human. We know that our job is to glorify God and enjoy Him forever. And He receives the most glory when we're loving others for Him and through Him because we've chosen to open our eyes. We each have gifts. Adam, Simone, and Stephen are incredible musicians. Elijah and Mia are the kindest people you will ever meet. And Owen has the best impression of a sim I've ever seen. Every other person behind me has their own talents, passions, and paths. We have the tools to lead others across the country. We're going far, and I think that can be figurative, even though I meant it literally. Our reach won't end at Veritas. In a few months, we're moving to Arkansas, Florida, Illinois, Michigan, California, New Hampshire, England. I hope that with these opportunities, each of us will choose to do the hard but fulfilling thing and will love others to help build God's kingdom. Veritas, class of 2023, you give me hope. Of course, we've had to learn these wonderful attributes. Honestly, we can take very little credit ourselves, as most of the virtues we struggle to display are simply our imitations and interpretations of the people around us. First, I would like to thank the families of the class of 2023 seniors for supporting us, praying for us, loving us, and sending us to a school as enriching as Veritas. I'd like to thank our teachers for tolerating our sometimes misguided but always enthusiastic passion and for giving us outlets to express that energy. Thank you for showing us what we ought and ought not to love and for giving us the skills and confidence we'll need wherever our next steps may be. Thank you to the Student Life team for planning fun events for us and giving us the space to breathe and just be kids. Thank you to the maintenance and security teams for always offering a good morning and for keeping our school beautiful and safe. Thank you to our administration for showing us what it looks like to work hard and put your all into something. Thanks for admitting us year after year despite having met us. Thank you for your dedication to the school and for creating a welcoming culture. Thank you to the underclassmen for being our friends. We'll miss y'all next year. Thank you to God for giving us such a great community and for showing your omniscience, power, mercy, and goodness through it. Thank you to my friends seated behind me. Thanks for sticking through to the end and for being exactly the right people at the right time for myself and each other. Mark 4:1-20 tells the parable of seeds planted in many different environments. We are the seeds planted in good soil. We were gifted Veritas as our environment. In many ways, we've been sheltered from the weeds and thorns of adversity. Our weeds have been fought off together in this community, and we are stronger for it. Over the past however many years, we have grown our roots in God and the gospel. Now those roots can help us establish ourselves as beacons of hope, charity, and God's glory in a fallen world. Through this paideia and these roots, we will all grow up to be the valiant representations of God, no matter how slow and hard the path may be. Thank you one last time to Veritas for allowing me to speak today and for letting me grow. Congratulations, class of 2023. We did it.
It is a nice night. My name is Jeff Fowler. I'm the head of school, and it is my job, my privilege now, to present our Veritas Valiant Award. Let me read the award to you. It begins with a preamble. In addition to Veritas Academy's recognitions for the good man speaking well, our senior thesis laureate, and the most exemplary scholars, our valedictorian and salutatorian, we also recognize one who leaves behind a legacy of leading with the heart in the betterment of self and others for the glory of God, our Veritas Valiant. As educators, parents, and mentors, it is incumbent upon us to challenge each young person entrusted to our care to focus on and cultivate mastery over the only three things in this world that they and they alone completely control: their attitude, their effort, and their tongue. Their attitude determines the joy and satisfaction they find in life, and it defines and especially limits their possibilities. The cynic has little potential. Their effort determines where they will reside within that realm of possibilities. Ambition, or perhaps more accurately, desire, is the fuel of the engine of effort. Either selfish desire or noble ambition will drive effort, though the latter more broadly and sustainably. But regardless the motive, noble or otherwise, desire without effort is without impact. And finally, their tongue has the power to undo it all. It's the match that most of us use to destroy in an instant what we have spent countless hours building. In many ways, the Veritas Valiant Creed is simply a codification of the attitudes and efforts and their underlying desires, along with the words behind a life that produces meaningful substance, influence, and fulfillment. This award recognizes a person whose life well lived commands the respect and appreciation of those around him. It is for the broadly influential person who, in his or her time at Veritas, had the heart and ability to bring out the best in others while challenging all to become even better and more Christ-like, continuing a legacy of sacrificial servant leadership at the Academy. Now for the creed. The Veritas Valiant Award, the Academy's highest honor, is meant to acknowledge a graduating senior whose life is marked not just by intellect and accomplishment, but also by effective leadership, a spirit of excellence, and personal virtue. The award is conferred upon one who possesses and pursues the aspirational, noble qualities we desire to see embodied in a person of whom others would remark, "Now there is a Veritas man or woman." That ideal is the good man speaking well, the courageous defender who rises above his fear to uphold truth and protect the vulnerable, the selfless servant leader prepared, assured, and poised, the tenacious competitor, gracious in victory, resilient in defeat, the contagiously joyful, hopeful, positive encourager of others, the patient, sincere listener, discerner of the heart and intents of others, the witty, inquisitive, contemplative soul, appreciative of silence and solitude, the champion of justice, but abounding in grace and mercy, the lover of all that is good, true, and beautiful, drinking deeply of it, the thankful, grateful child of God and winsome witness of Christ in word and in deed, a man after God's own heart, faithful friend of the Almighty. Our Valiant Award designee is a worthy ambassador for the institution, one we are proud to bear the imprimatur of Veritas Academy. As always, this year's Valiant winner is still in the process of becoming, but this student has consistently demonstrated most of the qualities I just described. This person has had a broad influence by leading well in the classroom, in co-curriculars, in clubs, in the house system, and in student congress. Over the last 4 years, our award winner has earned multiple academic excellence awards and character awards that attest to a consistent exhibition of passion, diligence, and leadership. Yet this student's most enduring legacy lies not in these achievements, but in the foundation of all, that of devotion to Christ. With faith as the source of all efforts, this student pursues creatively and excellence, encouraging others toward their own pursuit of the Creator. This student is well known as a grateful child of God, consistently thanking those who serve, help, and lead him. He then responds by being visible and active in the community, helping underclassmen in the halls of school and in the commons. As in years past, this student has set himself apart not just by his great achievements, but by the strength of his character and willingness to do the right thing. We ask for feedback from our teachers, coaches, fine arts leaders, student life leaders, seniors, and students in other grade levels, and all have stated their opinion that this student is worthy of this honor. For the class of 2023, the 12th annual Veritas Valiant is awarded to Mr. Joshua Robert Underwood. All right, one more thing, Josh. You may recall a new part of our Valiant Award. After witnessing several Veritas graduation ceremonies and being impressed with the caliber of the young men and women recognized as Valiants, a couple who wished to remain anonymous approached us several years ago with their desire to begin honoring the annual winner of this award by allowing the Valiant to direct a significant monetary contribution to a charitable cause or program about which the Valiant is passionate. So Josh, this will be your year to direct the Valiant Grant, a one-time donation of $3,000 to the charitable organization of your choosing. And I'll visit with you later about the details, but in the meantime, please begin thinking and praying about what cause dear to you would be most blessed by and make the best use of this very generous gift. Congratulations, Josh. We will now present our candidates for graduation.
Elijah James Badger. Elijah Thomas Blythe, with recognitions in liberal arts, mathematics, and foreign language. Ashton Hope Boyer, with recognition in liberal arts. Andrew Van Bibber Brawley IV, with recognitions in leadership and humanities. Andrew Livingston Brimmer, with recognition in athletics. Adam John Bile, with recognitions in liberal arts and fine arts. Adam is also a National Merit Scholar finalist and a National Merit Scholarship recipient. Jonathan Calvin Calvert. Wade Taylor Carnes, with recognition in liberal arts. Joshua Siu Chan. Benjamin Neil Clark with recognitions in leadership, humanities, liberal arts, and fine arts. Benjamin Miller Cox. Stephen Robert Cuellar. Nicholas Cruz Dieters. Paul Baltazar Diaz III. Harper Lillian Doris. Claire Marie Finch with recognition in liberal arts. Jacob Daniel Frazier with recognition in mathematics. Owen King Furley. Samuel Walker Haygood with recognitions in humanities, liberal arts, mathematics, and foreign language. Sam is also a National Merit Scholar finalist and our thesis laureate. Michael Aaron Hatfield with recognitions in liberal arts and athletics. Lane Lloyd Hayes. Grace Ellen Herstad with recognitions in humanities, science, and foreign language. Grace is also a National Merit Commended Scholar. Hallie Reeves Kirsten with recognitions in humanities, liberal arts, science, and foreign language. Margaret Ray Lambden with recognitions in humanities, liberal arts, and foreign language. Yeah. Mia Francis Liu. Aiden Geronimo Marenko with recognitions in foreign language and athletics. Josiah Mark Merriman. Patrick Anton Morgan. Hayden Daniel Peckman with recognition in humanities. Eve Catherine Pickering with recognitions in leadership, humanities, liberal arts, and science. Benjamin Elliott Potts with recognition in humanities. Hope Camille Presley with recognition in fine arts. Graham Anthony Rooker. Sadie Barbara Beth Sockleben. Braden Tyler Smith with recognitions in liberal arts, mathematics, and fine arts. Braden is also a National Merit Commended Scholar. Ethan James Smith. Simon Tarabia. Simone Murray Thompson with recognitions in liberal arts and fine arts. Quinn Thomas Ullman. Nice. Joshua Robert Underwood with recognitions in leadership, humanities, liberal arts, fine arts, and foreign language. Joshua is also a National Merit Commended Scholar and our Veritas Valiant. Nathaniel James Valley with recognitions in humanities and liberal arts. Jordan Lewis Vermont with recognition in leadership. Michaela Jan Vermont. Philip Charles Vogt with recognition in liberal arts. Rebecca Louise Wallace with recognition in humanities. Bronwyn Claire Britt Warner with recognitions in liberal arts, fine arts, science, and foreign language. Elijah Matthew Zimmel with recognition in humanities.
With my mic. Congratulations, graduates. I'm sure y'all could not hear them, but they were just loving, encouraging their people the entire time. Maybe teasing them a little bit, but it was just a lot of fun to hear. Next, we have an incredible speaker that's here today, and that is Micah Davidson. Pastor Micah Davidson received his Master's of Divinity with Biblical Languages from Southwestern Seminary in Fort Worth, Texas. He later completed his PhD in theology from the same institution. 12 years ago, Pastor Davidson moved to Austin and started a church in his living room in Circle C. Over the last 12 years, Real Life Church has met in 9 portable locations, including Clayton Elementary School, Gorzicki Middle School, and Bowie High School. Real Life Church now has a permanent home on 25 acres just 2 miles south of Circle C, where it began. The church family has grown from the first service, attendance of 18 people, to over 3,000 people gathering on FM 1826 this past Easter weekend. Pastor Davidson's greatest source of pride and joy is his wife Rebecca and their 5 children, ages 17 to 26, along with 2 grandkids and 2 golden retrievers. Please join me in welcoming our speaker, Pastor Micah Davidson.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here on such a historic day and a beautiful night, and what a great occasion as well. So wonderful to see just everybody surrounding these incredible graduates and celebrating them. I want to thank President Fowler, the board, department heads, the faculty. Special thank you to Angie for that great introduction. Can you come introduce me every time? That was amazing. It was incredible. All the other honored guests, of course, parents, family, and while we're all here, these exceptional graduates behind me. I was just told by one of the board that this is an historic day because this graduating class was born the day this vision was born. So Veritas started 2004. That's when they were born. It's the power of vision. Somebody knew we're going to build something for people who aren't here yet. So what an awesome day. And it's the largest graduating class so far. So very honored. I'm very honored to be Harper's pastor. I've enjoyed watching her grow in wisdom and stature and favor with God and man. I just want you to know, Harper, I'm really proud of you. I'm also really proud of Josh. What an amazing award, my friend. Incredible. Also, Margaret, incredible speech. There's no way I can top that, but it was awesome. And I'm also just proud of all of you guys, just getting to know you and hearing your accomplishments. And so I thought about what could I say with all these incredible insights you've gained from this faculty, as well as all of the advice and wisdom you've received from your parents. And I just thought and prayed about what could I share that would close out this chapter of your life and open up a new exciting chapter that you're about to embark on, a new adventure pursuing God's unique purpose for you. So, when I look at the days like you guys look, those of you who are around my age, we're living in the days of Daniel, where you look out and you see what's happening in culture and you're saying, is there any hope? And then all of a sudden you go to books like Daniel and you read about a young man who is a lot like these young people behind me. And Daniel was an exceptional leader in this world, just like you guys are going to be. And so I thought I would get on Veritas's website, before I came up here. And the very first thing the website asked me is Veritas right for you? So I was like, man, I need to read more because I'm about to speak, so see what's going to say. And then all of a sudden I flip through and it says, we train hearts and minds for the glory of God. We aim to produce men and women of wisdom and virtue, winsome valiance full of wit, grace, and grit. Oh, wow, what a place. And I want you guys behind me to know that that's who you are. You're like Daniel. Now, Daniel was a young man about your age, and he was just going through the familiar things. All this is familiar to you, this campus, these people, this faculty, and then he went to the unfamiliar like you're about to go to. You see, he was just hanging out at Jerusalem High School, and I'm sure it was called Veritas, being in Jerusalem and all. But all of a sudden, his country was invaded, and a guy named Nebuchadnezzar came in and took over and took Daniel and a lot of his friends from that high school hundreds of miles away from home, just like you're about to go. Some of you hundreds of miles away from home, and now all of a sudden Daniel didn't have all these people that are around him, doesn't have all the family, doesn't have all that familiarity, doesn't have his high school. What is Daniel going to do? Now all of a sudden his parents aren't there to wake him up. His parents aren't there to say, where are you going? He's got no accountability, doesn't have the faculty going, what are you writing on the whiteboard now? What are you counting? No comment. But all of a sudden he didn't have this support network. And so what is Daniel going to do? And he does what I'm praying that you are going to do, and that is make the right decisions when only God is watching. Live for an audience of one. And he remembers the Lord is with him, and he remembers the challenge and the decision he makes to be a person of character, of faith, and as Veritas's website says, a person of grace and grit for his generation. So you know the story. King Nebuchadnezzar told them, this is what I want you to eat, this is what I want you to drink, this is what you're going to do. And Daniel stood up because he knew the word of God, like you behind me know the word of God. And he said, you know what? I'm not going to do that. And he had conviction. You know why? Because Daniel had actually memorized verses in the book of Leviticus, which is very impressive. And he knew that God's people don't do certain things, and he was called to be different. And you can't be light if you look like darkness. And so he decided to shine, and I'm just going to give you this one verse, Daniel 1:8. It's this, the hinge pin of the whole book. It says, Daniel resolved not to defile himself with the king's food or with the wine that they drank. At that moment, He literally wrote the rest of his book. He literally wrote the rest of his life, and we still look at these life lessons. And so for just a few minutes, I want to share with you what were Daniel's choices, what were his life lessons, to understand that greatness is not today. Greatness is not where you're going to go to school, what you're going to do for a career. Greatness is the choices you're going to make from this point on, because the way you got here is choices, and the way you're going to impact life and this world is through great choices. Great choices make greatness. So how could I get you to remember four whole principles that I'm going to share in just 8 minutes? Well, I thought about what is an object that you're going to see after this. What will you see every day? You know, I thought maybe a book, because you're so studious and you got so many accolades. You read books every day, right? Well, there might be a day you don't look at a book. So I want to think of something else. So what do you see every day? Then I thought like crumble cookie. But then I thought, wow, you're going to eat it too quick. And there may be somewhere you go that you don't see a crumble cookie. So then I thought of an object that you see. You're going to see this no matter where you go. I just know it. A fork. Say a fork. What does that have to do with anything? Because Daniel decided what he was going to stick his fork in, okay? And all of a sudden, he had this decision, and a fork, any fork you use, I checked this out across the world, it has four different ways to pick up something. So if you just remember the word fork, then you can remember these four life lessons, these choices that Daniel makes. So I'm going to get you to participate because I can't tell if you're falling asleep behind me. But anyway, the F is for friends. Friends will make you or they will break you. I tell this to my kids who are grown now, and if I see you in 10 years and you're going like, how am I doing in my walk? How am I doing in my faith? How am I doing in my potential? Am I reaching my potential for significance? I'm just going to ask you, introduce me to your friends. And the minute I meet your three closest friends is the moment I'm going to tell you if you're achieving greatness, if you're really achieving all that you can accomplish, because 1 Corinthians 15:33 says, bad company corrupts good character, so don't be fooled. Your friends are your future. So always have good friends. You are where you are right now, sitting right here, because you have exceptional friends. You made it here because of all the people around you. They push you higher. Literally, you're higher than you ever would have been on your own. I was talking to Sam the other day, and Sam was telling me about the achievements of the basketball team, and I didn't know the context of Veritas very well. I was like, tell me about that. He goes, yeah, we beat JP too. And I was like, awesome. But I didn't know what a JP2 was. Thought maybe like a Star Wars robot that I'd missed in some of the earlier Star Wars. Maybe JP2 was like an opening rapper for Eminem at ACL last year. I did a JP2. Then he's like, no, it's John Paul. I was like, oh, okay, I got it. And went all the way to the finals. Same with the volleyball, girls volleyball team, and even the pole vaulter back here, one state. So we get a lot of, how did Sam do that? Where you're like, well, because he's tall, obviously. And he can obviously, now we know he can write a thesis and defend it. But he had a great team. You know what Sam did? He didn't talk about his accomplishments, but his team. He talked about the people around him. He talked about the achievement he had because of the people around him. Who was on Daniel's team in the book of Daniel? He had three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. What did those guys do? When they were faced with, all you can do is take the easy route, bow down to false gods, and we'll leave you alone, or you can stand for God, we're going to throw you in a fiery furnace, they stood for God. They had conviction. Those are the friends you want. Whenever you go in life, look for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's, people who will walk through fire for God, and those are the people you want to hang out with. Find friends who will not bow down to false gods, but live with conviction like you are taught here. All right, so here we go, guys. The F is four. Okay, now I want you to say it like I'm the only person standing between you and graduation, okay? The F is four. Nice. Friends will make you or they will break you. The O is for opportunities. You're going to have opportunities every day. Opportunities will shape you. And Daniel has an opportunity in Daniel chapter 1, verse 8. And what I want you to realize is if that verse wasn't in there, you wouldn't have the book of Daniel. What if they had said, here's what you're going to do, and it's compromising, it's comfortable, it doesn't honor Christ, but just go ahead and do it. Nobody, everybody will leave you alone. If he had said, just, I'm not going to take the opportunity, no one would know his name. No one ever heard of him. Colossians 4:5 says, live wisely among those who are not believers and make the most of every opportunity. So do that. You're going to have so many opportunities as you leave here. Stand. Be an influence. Be a light for God. And just decide every day is a crossroads. I'm going to go God's way today. I'm going to do what he wants me to do. Greatness is not something out there. Greatness is the next right choice today. So every second is sacred. Take every opportunity and don't waste a second of it. So the F is for? Friends. You got it. The O is for? Right. Friends will make you or they break you. Opportunities will shape you. The R, resolutions will direct you. I just want to encourage you to write down some things before you go out to college, your next level of learning, wherever you're going to go in life after this. Just write down some guidelines that you'll say, you know what, I'm going to do this before I ever am faced with the decision to do it. I believe when Daniel wrote down resolutions, it wasn't at this day and this moment of Nebuchadnezzar and all the pressure. He had already decided, I'm going to be a man of character. I'm going to be a young person that stands for something. I'm not going to give in. I'm not going to do the comfortable thing. I'm not going to go with the crowd. I'm going to make a resolution to stand. So when the moment came, he was ready. So write some things down. Jonathan Edwards, arguably one of the greatest preachers in American history, when he was a young man your age, he wrote down 70 resolutions. 70 resolutions that he was going to live by. And so I thought what I would do is read all 70 right now. That was a joke. Okay. All right. Let me just read one. His very first one. He says, I'm resolved that I will do whatsoever I think to be most to God's glory. Sounds like he went to Veritas. He says, with all that I am, I will consider my time not my own, but for his glory. I'm resolved to do whatever I think, so be my duty and most for the good and advantage of mankind in general. Resolved to do this, whatever the difficulty I meet with, how many and how great whatsoever, I will bring glory to my God. Wow, Jonathan Edwards, he literally fortified 13 colonies into what we now know as our nation through passion and the pointing to the sovereignty of God over all things. And with that passion for freedom only found in faith in God, he changed everything. All right. So the F is for? Friends. Friends will make you or they'll break you. The O is for? Opportunities are going to shape you. Take advantage of them, especially the ones that are right in front of you. Do the next right thing. The R is for? Resolutions. Write some down. Let them direct you. And let me just, before I give you the last one, just say, this is interesting. So you may, people in their 80s were interviewed and they were asked, what would you do different if you could go back to your graduation? I thought that was an interesting question. Like 80 years old, can you remember your graduation? Anyway, so it's like, hey, what would you do different if you could go back and talk to yourself? Number one answer, I would tell myself to take more risks. Now, when I really dug into this and looked at it, it wasn't like this, hey, just be, you know, more risky behavior for the sake of risk. But basically, when you read the answers, it was don't settle, dream big, don't blend into the crowd, blaze a trail for righteousness, just like Daniel did. He didn't blend in. He took the opportunity to be different. He made some resolutions. Now, just like all the people who have gathered here, I have been in your shoes. We have 5 kids. 4 of them have already graduated, so I've been in your shoes 4 times already. And there's mixed emotions, and I get it. I almost feel like a parent when I watch them walk into first grade with a lunchbox bigger than them. It's the same feeling when I have when they're graduating, like there they go. But I just want to encourage all of us to pray for these behind me, that they will know that it's not about their career choice as much as their character, and that they will bring glory to God and live for an audience of one, and know that when they do so, they will make us the most proud, because they will impact the world and they'll impact God's kingdom and they'll push back darkness with the light and love of Jesus. So I don't have time to brag on all my kids, but just a couple of them. But our oldest daughter, Allie, she graduated, she went on to college, she had accolades, she had an English major, got all these offers from all over the world, literally, and great money, great prestige and everything else. You know what she chose to do? She chose to work for a sex trafficking nonprofit organization that fights sex trafficking all over the world, especially India and Indonesia, and literally has traveled there so many times. And she writes about young girls and their lives at age 9, 10, 11, and how they're being rescued off the street from horrific things. And her writing is literally going all over the world, but she doesn't get paid very much. And I don't care, because she's bringing glory to God. My oldest son, Will, incredible musician. He actually got an offer in Nashville from a record label, you know, and he's got the look, the sound, and everything else. They were just really, and he comes to me and he says, Dad, I'm going to Nicaragua. I said, did you just say Nashville? I said, no, I said Nicaragua. Is that a record label in Nashville? And he had heard about, through our church and some things we do in Nicaragua, he lives there now. And it's the most dangerous neighborhood in Nicaragua. And he's been sharing Christ there for over 2 years now. And when your kid tells you these things, you just have to pray harder, because now in Nicaragua, over these last 2 years, through Will and a whole bunch of other young people that are absolutely passionate and willing to do anything for Christ, the two leading gang members in Pantanal, Nicaragua, have been saved. So now they are sharing with the gang members what it means to live for Jesus. And when you want to see somebody be courageous and passionate for Jesus, see a gang member get saved. And so through our church and other people, very generous like you guys with all these grants I've been hearing about, we bought the number one piece of property known for selling drugs to young people in Pantanal and built a community center. And the people that work at the community center are the converted gang members. They're the ones that are the bodyguards. So when they know all the drug dealers in town, so here comes a drug dealer to the community center, and they're like, you better turn around, I'm going to kill you. Okay? And all of a sudden, you've got young people having a safe place to read and learn and be on the weekend and have fun and not get into trouble. And I can just tell you that all of a sudden, I'm like, man, I'm so glad my son didn't go to Nashville and become the next Justin Bieber. I'm so glad he's bringing glory to God and being a Daniel for his generation. All right, last kid I'm going to brag on is the son we adopted from Africa when he was 5 years old. And he's taught us so much about life. When he first came home, he walked up to our refrigerator, and my oldest son, Will, taught Eli. He's like, this is how it works, man. You take this cup and you put it in the door and the water comes out. Eli's looking at it like, wow. And then all of a sudden, Eli says this that just shatters our hearts. He goes, how many times a day can I do that? I mean, you can do this whenever you want to. You can do it whenever I want to. Yeah. He came from a village with no running water, no electricity, one doctor for every 189,000 people. And all of a sudden, he's growing up in our home and finds Christ, finds life, finds purpose. And Eli actually went to Biola University on almost a full ride scholarship. He got the first family to go to college scholarship. When he wrote his paper, it wasn't, I'm not the first person in my family to go to college. I'm the first person in my whole village to go to college. Matter of fact, I'm the first person in the upper region of northern Ghana to ever see an airplane. And not only did he graduate from Biola, now he's at the University of California getting a master's in computer engineering and science. Now, when I talked to Eli recently, I was like, man, I'm so proud of you, son. You're going to graduate next May. This is going to be amazing. You are my retirement program. You're going to invent things. He's got apps that he's got, you know, different patents that he's working on. He said, no, Dad, you don't understand. As soon as I graduate, I'm moving back to Ghana. I'm like, really? He goes, yeah. He goes, because I'm going to invent a solar panel that you could put in our village, because all the kids in that village, Dad, let it sink in, Dad. I'm from Villa, no running water, no electricity. I'm working math problems with the most famous mathematicians in the world now. And that means every kid in Ghana can do this. They just don't have the means or the ability or the capacity of education because they work in a field all day. So I'm going to get these solar panels going. Lights are going to come on. And we're going to study math all day, all night after they're going to do agricultural things. And then we're going to develop computer chips and everything from northern Ghana that are going to change the world. I just kind of step back and go, wow, you know. Friends, they'll make you or they'll break you. Opportunities will shape you. Resolutions will direct you. So take the opportunities. Dream big. Take risks for God and know that he's with you and know that his math doesn't work out in the world's math, but as long as you're living for his glory, this group will be proud. Now, the K, it only works because I'm from Mississippi, everybody. Okay, so actually, I passed through Mississippi for 5 years. But at any rate, the K is kin. Now, if you're from Mississippi, you know that that's family, okay? And I want you to look around, students, to look at all this family because they're here. Did you hear how much they were applauding? Some of them actually yelled. You aren't supposed to yell, but some are like, woo-hoo, like they were like really going crazy. You know why? Because they're like, I'm so glad it's done. I changed their diapers. I taught them to walk. I taught them how to ride a bike, and they almost died. I taught them how to drive, and I almost died. And I'm so glad. I forced them to go to class, and they're like, I don't want to go. And I told them to get there, and now they're here. And so they applauded you. And so I thought before I close, you could just take about 25 seconds in just 1 minute, and I'm going to get you to stand up and applaud them. And you already know where they're sitting because you already spotted them when you walked in. And so just for 20 seconds, I'm just going to get you to just stand up and look right at them, and you applaud the people that came here to applaud your achievement. Cool? All right, so let's do it. Find them and applaud them. Stand up. Give them a standing ovation. They're everywhere. There they are. I know nobody wants to be the first one to sit down, so you guys did great. All right? Now listen to me. Do that every day. Because the reason they're down there and you're up here is because they've lifted you up with everything they've got. And they believe you can go far. So go far. And when you don't see them, applaud them with how you live, the choices you make, and be a Daniel for your generation. This fork has a handle, and that handle is truth. Veritas. Veritas means truth. And the Hebrew word for truth is the word emet. I learned this when I was traveling in Israel recently, that the Hebrew alphabet is actually used in doubles for numbers as well. In other words, the first letter in the alphabet, Aleph, is actually the number one. Bet is actually the number two, and so on. The word emet, truth, is two words together. The first one, Aleph, which is number one, which is God, and then met. And this is interesting. If you take God, number one, out of emet, then you get just the word met, and the word met in Hebrew is death. You take God out of truth and you don't have truth. You put God into your life and you have truth. So as a Christian, I was listening to this rabbi explain this to me, and I just got this overwhelming revelation that I was dead in my trespasses and sin, and God put skin on and walked among us. And he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. And he proved it by dying on a cross and coming back to life, so that when he steps into my life, now I know truth, because now I know Jesus. So wherever you go in life, hold on to the lessons of Daniel and hold on to truth, hold on to Jesus, hold on to Veritas.
Thank you, Pastor Davison. Well, we should have got those string lights up, huh? All right, now I would like to ask those students whose entire education, 12 or 13 years worth, has been spent at Veritas, I'd like for you to please rise and remain standing. 12, 13 years, rise and stand up. All right. If you're a student who's been here 10 or more years, please rise and join them. All right, now all the graduates, please rise. So before we pronounce our graduates, I'd like for you to join me in praying a blessing over them. Father, thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you for this beautiful evening. Thank you for breath in our bodies and just the joy it is to be alive and to be with young people. Father, we lift up these young people behind me to you. Father, we ask for your grace and your mercy to abound to them. We ask that you give them clarity of direction, that you give them experience to cultivate wisdom in them. Father, we pray that they will pursue you with all of their hearts, and that, Lord, you would keep them on the straight and narrow. Father, we pray not for an easy life for them, but a meaningful, substantive, impactful one. And we know, Father, that strength comes from struggle, so please don't spare them the struggle that they need in order to grow strong. May they even taste a little heartache to cultivate compassion in their own hearts. Bless them. Lord, they have been a blessing to me and to this community for so long. And I just thank you for the opportunity you've given me to be a part of their lives this year. Pour out your goodness on them, Father. Never let them go. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, following our traditional tossing of the mortarboards, I invite you all to stay and enjoy a time of fellowship with each other and with our newest alums as they make their way down for photographs. On the side, I believe it's the north side of the stage over here, there are word collages for each graduate. After taking a photo, graduates, that is your gift to take with you this evening. Refreshments will be served in the first floor cafe of the academic building, and you are welcome to join us up there for cupcakes and punch. Juniors up on the hillside, you are seconds away from becoming seniors and the leaders of our school. But now, graduates, please take your tassels and move them from the right to the left as I pronounce you graduates of Veritas Academy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduated class of 2023. Onward and upward.